Welcome to lecture number 19. Lecture number 17 and 18 mein we started with the concept of liquidity of short-term assets related debt-paying ability. In this lecture, we will complete this topic. Now, what is an operating cycle? The operating cycle represents the period of time that elapses between the acquisition of goods and the final cash realization resulting from sales and subsequent collection. For example, आपने you are into manufacturing of goods, आपने goods के लिए you purchase raw material, आपने फिर उसको work in process बना, उधर से आपकी finished goods हुई, then you sold the goods and took it to cost of goods sold, or cost of goods sold से when you receive the cash against it, so that will be called the operating cycle. An approximation of the operating cycle can be determined from the receivables liquidity figures and inventory liquidity figures. Ab inventory liquidity figure, what does it show? Ye show karta hai ki wo inventory jo for sale ya for use in production aapne purchase ki hai, uski how much time does it take to liquidate? How much time does it take to get used? और फिर जो आपका सेकंड आता है अकाउंट रिसीवेबल के उस इन्वेंट्री के अगेंस्ट जब आपको पेमेंट रिसीव हो गई है सो दैट कैन बी अ रफ एस्टीमेट ऑफ द ऑपरेटिंग साइकिल ऑफ अ कंपनी. इसका फॉर्मूला है ऑपरेटिंग साइकिल इज इक्वल टू अकाउंट रिसीवेबल टर्नओवर इन डेज प्लस इन्वेंट्री टर्नओवर इन डेज. एंड ये जो आपका एग्जिबिट 611 है it shows the how do you calculate the operating cycle. Aapki jo account receivable turnover in days hai 2009 mein that was 55.15 days aur jo aapka inventory turnover in days tha that was 82.79. so jo aapka operating cycle tha in year 2009 that was 137.94 days. The estimate of the operating cycle is not realistic if the account receivable turnover in days and the inventory turnover in days are not realistic. Remember that the account receivable turnover in days and the inventory turnover in days are understated, and thus the liquidity is overstated if the company uses a natural business year and computed and averages based on beginning of the year and end of year data. हमने पढ़ा था कि natural business year में जो बिगिनिंग और एंडिंग में एक्टिविटीज आर स्लो, जब व्हेन द एक्टिविटी इज स्लो तो ऑब्वियसली योर अकाउंट रिसीवेबल विल आल्सो बी लेस और आपका इन्वेंट्री टर्नओवर विल आल्सो बी अंडरस्टेटेड. इफ द कंपनी यूजेस अ नेचुरल बिजनेस ईयर एंड कंप्यूटेड द एवरेजेस बेस्ड ऑन द बिगिनिंग ऑफ ईयर एंड एंड ऑफ ईयर डेटा सो द एस्टिमेट ऑफ ऑपरेटिंग साइकिल विल बी रॉन्ग. It should also be remembered that the inventory turnover in days is understated and liquidity of the inventory overstated if the company uses LIFO inventory, as we did when we were discussing the LIFO section. In addition, it should be noted that the account receivable turnover in days is understated and the liquidity of receivables overstated if the sales figures used included cash and credit sales. That is why we discussed that we should always look at the net sales figure carefully to differentiate between the cash sales and the credit sales. The operating cycle should be helpful when comparing a firm from period to period and when comparing a firm with similar companies. This would be the case even if understated or overstated, as long as the figures in the computation are comparable. Now, prepayments. Prepayment consists of unexpired costs for which payment has been made. These current assets are expected to be consumed within the operating cycle or 1 year. For example, prepayment mein aata hai aapka prepayment for the rent. Ab if you have paid rent for 6 months, so obviously aapka wo prepaid hai and that is expected to be consumed within the year. Prepayments normally represent an immaterial portion of the current assets. Therefore, they have little influence on the short-term debt-paying ability of the firm. Since prepayments have been paid for and will not generate cash in the future, they differ from other current assets. Prepayments relate to short-term debt-paying ability of the entity. because they conserve the use of cash. Because of the nature of prepayments, the problem of valuation and liquidity are handled in a simple manner. Valuation is taken as the cost that has been paid. Obviously, आपने अगर if you have paid rent for 6 months, तो उसकी जो valuation है वो वही होगा जो आपने in form of rent advance pay किया हुआ है. Since a prepayment is current asset that has been paid for in a relatively short period before the balance sheet date, the cost paid fairly represents the cash used for the prepayment. How the amount of rent that you have paid in advance, obviously wo aapki cost hai because it is a very short period of time. An example of a circumstance where cash is received and would be insurance policy cancelled early, no liquidity computation is possible even in this case. Other current assets. Current assets other than cash, marketable securities, receivable, inventories, and prepayments may be listed under current assets. These other current assets may be very material in any 1 year, and unless they are recurring, may distort the firm's liquidity. These assets will, in management's opinion, be realized in cash or conserve the use of cash within the operating cycle of the business or 1 year, whichever is longer. Examples of जो आपकी other current assets की example हो सकती हैं वो होती है property held for sale and advances or deposits. And normally these are explained in the notes which accompany the financial statements. Current liabilities. Current liabilities are obligations whose liquidation is reasonably expected to require the use of existing resources, properly classifiable as current assets, or the creation of other current liabilities. So current liabilities ko on obligations ko, how do you take care of those obligations? Using the current assets or by creating other current liabilities. So agar aapka bank mein loan hai, either you will pay that loan through cash, which is your current asset, or you can take another loan to pay that loan, which is the generation of a new current liability. Thus, the definition of current liabilities correlates with the definition of current assets. Typical items found in current liabilities includes account receivable, notes payable. जैसे आप इसमें देखेंगे, this is a typical करंट लाइबिलिटी सेक्शन. आपकी करंट लाइबिलिटीज में करंट पोर्शन ऑफ लॉन्ग टर्म डेट आ गया, वो डेट जो आपने विद इन दी फाइनेंशियल पीरियड पे करना है. फिर आपके नोट्स पेबल है, अकाउंट्स पेबल है, एक्रूड लाइबिलिटीज हैं. वो एक्रूड लाइबिलिटीज वो लाइबिलिटीज होती हैं जो आपका एक्सपेंस तो इनकर हो गया बट यू हैव स्टिल नॉट एंटर्ड इट. इनकम टैक्सेस पेएबल, ये आपकी कम्स टू टोटल करंट लाइबिलिटीज. Current assets compared. So when you compare current assets with current liabilities, so you can come up with four different ratios. The ratio number one is called working capital. The working capital of a business is an indication of the short-term solvency of the business. Iska formula simple hota hai, current assets minus current liabilities. Exhibit 612 presents the working capital for Nike at the end of year 9 and 8. Nike had this much in working capital in 2009 and this much in working capital in 2008. These figures tend to be understated because some of the current assets such as inventory may be understated based on the book figure. Ab ye aapki current assets the 2009 ke current liabilities thi. So how do you calculate the working capital? When you subtract current liabilities from current assets. The inventory as reported may be much less than its replacement cost. The difference between the reported inventory amount and the replacement amount is normally material when the firm is using LIFO. Jab humne LIFO kiya to humne kaha tha ki replacement cost is always high. The difference may also be material when using one of the other cost methods, like FIFO may be material ho sakta hai aapka difference, weighted average may be jo difference hoga wo material ho sakta hai nature mein. The current working capital amount should be compared with past amounts to determine if working capital is reasonable. Because the relative size of a company may be expanding or contracting, comparing the working capital of one firm with that of another firm is usually meaningless because of the size of their operations. Current ratio. Another indicator, the current ratio determines short-term debt-paying ability and is computed as follows. Current ratio is equal to current assets divided by current liability. So working capital tha current asset minus current liability. Current ratio hai current assets divided by current liabilities. Exhibit 613 presents the current ratio for Nike. For many years, the guidelines for the minimum current ratio has been 2. Until the mid-1960s, the typical firm usually maintained a current ratio of 2 or better. Since that time, the current ratio of many firms has declined to a point below the 2 guideline. Currently, many firms are not successful in staying above a current ratio of 2. This indicates a decline in the liquidity of many firms. It also could indicate better control of receivable and or inventory. A comparison with industry averages should be made to determine the typical current ratio for other firms. In some industries, a current ratio substantially below 2 is adequate, while other industries require a much larger ratio. In general, the shorter the operating cycle, the lower the current ratio. The longer the operating cycle, the higher the current ratio. The current ratio is considered to be more indicative of the short-term debt-paying ability than the working capital. Working capital only determines the absolute difference between the current assets and current liabilities. Remember, working capital is equal to current asset minus current liabilities. The current ratio shows the relationship between the size of the current assets and the size of the current liabilities, making it feasible to compare the current ratio. For example, when we talk about IBM and Intel, so you will see that unke jo a comparison of the working capital of these two firms would be meaningless because IBM is larger firm than Intel. So unka, because there is so much difference, to jo usme aap current ratio nikalte hain, that becomes meaningless. Usme difference bahut zyada aata hai. Asset test ratio, it is also called quick ratio. The current ratio evaluates an enterprise overall liquidity position, considering current assets and current liabilities. At times, it is desirable to assess a more immediate position than that indicated by the current ratio. The asset test or quick ratio relates the most liquid assets to current liabilities. Usme what you do, you remove inventory when computing the asset test ratio. Some of the reasons for removing inventory are that inventory may be slow moving or possibly obsolete, and parts of the inventory may have been pledged to specific creditors. So aapka jo asset test ratio hai, usme you subtract inventory from your current assets and then you divide it by current liabilities. Exhibit 614 presents the asset test ratio for Nike at the end of year 9 and 8. For Nike, the asset test ratio was 2.25 at the end of Itna and 1.93 at the end of 8. This represents a positive trend. It may also be desirable to exclude some other items from current assets that may not represent current cash flow, such as prepaid and miscellaneous. Compute the more conservative asset test ratio. So asset test ratio has two formulas. One is current assets minus inventory over current liabilities. The more conservative one is cash equivalent or cash plus marketable securities plus net receivables, you divide it by current liabilities. For many years, the guideline for the minimum asset test was 1. A comparison should be made with the firm's past asset test ratio and with major competitors and industry averages. Some industries find that a ratio less than 1 is adequate, while others need a ratio greater than 1. For example, a grocery store may sell only for cash and not have receivables. This type of business can have an asset test ratio substantially below the 1 ratio guideline and still have adequate liquidity. Cash ratio. Sometimes when an analyst needs to view the liquidity of a firm's firm an extremely conservative point of view. For example, a company may have pledged its receivables and its inventory, or the analyst suspects severe liquidity problems with inventory and receivables. The best indicator of the company's short run liquidity may be the cash ratio. Compute the cash ratio as follows. So when we talk about cash ratio, we only include cash and marketable securities and divide it by current liabilities. So aapka ye jo cash ratio hai, it is a more rigid form than your एसिड टेस्ट रेशियो, और फिर आपका जो एसिड टेस्ट रेशियो है इट इज अ मोर रिजिड फॉर्म देन योर करंट रेशियो. Sales to working capital. Relating sales to working capital gives an indication of the turnover in working capital per year. The analyst needs to compare this ratio with the past with competitors. Now, what is the formula for sales to working capital? Sales divided by average working capital. A low working capital turnover is tentatively indicates an unprofitable use of working capital. In other words, sales are not adequate in relation to the average available working capital. A high ratio tentatively indicates that the firm is undercapitalized. It means it is overtrading. An undercapitalized firm is particularly susceptible to liquidity problems when a major adverse change in business conditions occurs. Iske liye formula aapka already given hai. You have net sales, working capital at the beginning of the year, at the end of the year, you find the average working capital from it, and then you divide the net sales figure by it, you get the sales to working capital ratio. liquidity considerations not on the face of the statements. Achha, when you look at the financial statements, so maybe the financials, whatever the message financial statement is conveying to you, maybe that is not the the true reality. For example, unused, bahut si jo aapke reasons ho sakte hain ki unused bank credit lines would be a positive addition to liquidity. They are frequently disclosed in notes. A firm may have some long-term assets that could be converted to cash quickly, but what we do when we are using these ratios, so we only look at the current assets. This would add to the firm's liquidity. Phir aapka, a firm may be in a very good long-term debt position and therefore have the capability to issue debt or stock. So this is another way to go around problem of having, you know, less cash to take care of your obligations. A firm may not be in as good a position of liquidity as indicated by the ratios, as the following examples show. A firm may have costs discounted on which the other party has full recourse against the firm. A firm may have major contingent liabilities that have not been recorded, such as a disputed tax claim. Agar aapka, let's say, contingent liability hai jo aapne record nahi ki bhi, aur agar wo occur ho jata hai, to obviously suddenly the figure for current liabilities will go up, and that will create problems for the company in the short term. A firm may have guaranteed a bank note for another company. This would be disclosed in a note. So this is the summary of all the ratios that we have done in 17, 18, 19. First, we did days sales and receivables, account receivable turnover, accounts receivable turnover and days. So the first three relate to the receivable section. Then you have days sales in inventory, inventory turnover, and inventory turnover in days. These three relate to inventory section. Then you have the operating cycle. I've told you is account receivable turnover in days plus inventory turnover in days. Then you have ratios which compare your current assets with your current liabilities. So first one is working capital. Then you have current ratio, asset test ratio, cash ratio, and sales to working capital. So this is the end of lecture number 19.